Hello friends, I, Mrs. Sampana Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. In this video series, I am covering the concept of trees, data structures in detail. In this current video, I am giving an introduction to binary tree traversal techniques. Before moving to the content, I would like to request you to please subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. Now let's see which different operations we can perform on different data structures in general. So in general, what do you mean by data structures and what are different types of data structures? If you want to know details about all these things, then I am flashing a shortcut link in this right up corner. You can go through that and then you can resume this video. So now let's see which operations can be performed on the data structures. So the operations are, first of all, we need to create the data structure. After creation of the data structures, we can insert the elements in the data structures. Then after creation, after insertion of the elements in the data structure, we can display all the contents of the data structure. Now my data structure is ready to perform all remaining operations. That is, if I am having some information in my data structure, then I can perform the search operation on that. With the help of search, I can delete or modify any of the element from my data structure. So these are the basic things that I can perform on the data structure. Now let's consider the data structure of tree, which we are focusing in this video series. So let's consider the binary tree, and the same operations if I want to perform on the binary tree, then what are we are going to do? So first of all, we need to create a binary tree. So this will be my first operation of the creation of the binary tree. After the creation of the binary tree, I can insert the elements in binary tree. Once after inserting the elements in my binary tree, I can display all the elements of the binary tree. Displaying the elements of the binary tree is also called as the traversal of the binary tree. Then we can perform different operations on a binary tree. They are, typically, we can copy a binary tree from one tree, original tree, to the duplicate copy of the tree by performing again the traversal of the tree. Then we can find out the height of the tree, we can find out the leaf nodes of the binary tree, and so on. So these typical operations we can perform on the binary trees, from which in this video session I am explaining you the display elements of the binary tree. As I explained previously, displaying the elements is nothing but the traversal of the binary tree. So now let's start with the traversal of the data structure binary tree. So traversal, it means displaying all the elements of the binary tree. This is one of the operations that can be performed on the tree data structure. As I explained in the previous slide, with the different operations, this is one of the operations that we can perform on the data structure tree. This is the way in which the user can pass through the all the elements which are present in the data structure. Now for example, if I am having a linear data structures like array, linked list, queues, stack, etc., then that linear data structures can be traversed in a single way only, in a single logical way only, which is nothing but we used to start from the beginning of the data structure and we traverse all the elements at the till the end of the data structures. This is the typical way of the traversal of the linear data structures. But The tree is the data structure which is non-linear data structures. So if it is non-linear data structures, we can traverse the tree in different ways. There are basically two different ways in which we can traverse the tree. They are depth first search, or we can say that depth first traversal of the tree, and breadth first traversal of the tree. Depth first traversal, there are again three ways in which we can traverse the tree with depth of the tree. They are pre-order traversal, in-order traversal, and post-order traversal. And breadth first traversal, that is nothing but we will traverse the tree level wise. Now let's move forward for the depth first search traversal, where we will go in depth of the tree. Now depth first traversal, here we are having three different ways in which we can traverse the tree. They are the pre-order, in-order, and post-order. This is the order is defined with the help of position of the root node of the binary tree. Now pre-order is nothing but the position of the root is pre or before the left and right child nodes of the root. So that's why whenever we will traverse the tree in pre-order, then root will be before to the left and right child. Whenever we will traverse the tree in in-order traversal, then the position of the root node will be in between of the left and right child of the root, or a parent node, we can say that. Here you can see that the root is present in between of the left and right child. And post-order traversal, where post is nothing but after. So root will be present after left and right child. So here I repeat, these three traversal techniques are depth first traversal technique, where the tree we are going to traverse in depth. The names of these traversal technique are given as per the position of the root node. So if the root node is before left and right child nodes, that traversal technique is called as pre-order traversal. If my root is present in between of the left and right child, then this traversing technique is called as in-order traversal. And if the root is present after processing the left and right child, then this technique is called as post-order traversal. In detail, I will explain all these traversal techniques in separate individual videos. So to understand the concept of pre-order, in-order, and post-order traversal, please stay tuned with my channel Tech Talks. Now let's move forward for the next traversing technique, is nothing but the breadth first search. So here is BFS, which is breadth first search traversal. This I am going to explain you with the help of example. I have given the example of binary tree. First of all, let's see what is best breadth first traversal. This is also called as level order traversal, where we will consider the level while traversing the tree. Always traverse starts with the root node. So first of all, we will process the root node 1. Processing means displaying the root node. So here we are displaying a root node first, that is 1. Then we will move to the next level of the tree. So next level, the elements are 2 and 3. Always start with the leftmost child of the level, any level which you wish to process. Start with the leftmost child and go forward for all the nodes which are present in that level. So here 2 is the leftmost node, so I will process first of all 2, then the next node which is present in my tree in the same level is 3, so that's why I will process first of all 2, then 3. Then I will move to the next level where the 4 is the leftmost node. So I will display 4. Then I will move to the 5 to process it. So here level order displays 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here you can see that 1 is the root level. Then 2, 3 is the level number 2 and 3, 4 are at the level number 3. So in this way we can traverse the tree if I want to traverse it level order or level wise. So thank you dear friends for listening and watching my video. I hope you are understanding the concept of trees. To know more about trees, stay tuned with my channel Tech Talks. Here I am providing you the subscription link for my channel, as well as I am providing you the next video session shortcut link and the playlist for this video series, tree data structures. Thank you.